And that's, so it's a story about two puppets that fall in love and then something happens to them. So,
without further ado,
Orpheus and Eurydice. Oh, come on. Once upon a time, a long time ago, there lived a legendary gifted musician named Orpheus. Orpheus was the son of Apollo, the god of music and Calliope. One day Orpheus's father gave him a golden lyre and taught him how to play it. After some poor practice, Orpheus mastered the ability to play the lyre. His songs could cast spells, soothe savage beasts, and charm all living things that heard it with his divinely gifted music. No god or mortal could resist, and even the rocks and trees would move themselves to be near him. Even the beautiful nymph, Eurydice, could not resist his charms. And as soon as the couple met, they were enraptured with love and chose to marry. Orpheus loved his wife and would do anything for her. And it wasn't until one fateful day that his love was truly tested. As they strolled off together, ready to walk into a future of happiness, Eurydice felt the sharp pain on her foot. It was the fangs of a snake. As Orpheus held her, her life slowly slipped from this world. And yet, Orpheus was not going to give up on his wife, and he decided to go to the underworld to speak to his uncle Hades. "You shall not pass. What is it you want here? You have no business here." "It is Eurydice, uncle. I need Eurydice, my wife, back in my life, back on earth. If there's anything I can do, what is the way, I beg of you, to tell me? Tell me. Tell me how my beloved wife and I can return. Under one condition. Anything! If you want to return to earth, you must trust me to walk out of hell and never look back." Of course I shall," screamed Orpheus. Orpheus knew in his heart that wherever he was, Eurydice was right behind him. And as he walked out, he longed to steal a glance for him. But he knew that he couldn't. Eventually, he got to the end of the tunnel and saw the light of the world. But as he got there, he slowly turned back. And as he turned back, the sight of Eurydice vanished before him. He clung out his arms, trying to capture her, but she slowly vanished with the one sad word of farewell ringing in his ears. And as he returned to earth, he looked back into the underworld, realizing he would never see his wife, and stared into his future with the memories of Eurydice in a state of desolation. Puppets ready? Are you going to bow, puppets? There we go. We have a bow, please, puppets. And hold hands and bow. Thank you. There you go. Thank you very much. Okay. And there you go. Wait for the children, puppets. Wait for the children. There you go. Wait for everyone there. There we go.